Welcome, sports bettors from around the world. This is your friend Joe, my friend Big Bon. What's up, Big Bon?
Yes, sir. What's up with you, Joe?
All right, good. Now you're, I mean, that's a very good yes, sir. Excited for me. Just want to let you know, and I talked to Big Bon before we shot the video here, that I will be in Vegas, guys. So if you're out there this weekend, I just booked the room at the South Point Hotel. Shout out to South Point. So give me some more free rooms. We'll be out there Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, and possibly Tuesday. So depending on the weekend, if we do really well, which I'm hoping, we'll stay there a little extra time. I know Johnny Appleseed, if you're watching this, I hope you are. He's going to be out there with his girlfriend. Big Mom's going to be out there next month by himself. Or with your girlfriend, I forget. I got to bust your chops. Sorry, girlfriend, I just like to mess with Big Mom. But Big Mom will be out there the 18th. Boogie, though, Boogie on, shout out to you, that's going to cancel on us. He said that, oh, it's just you, Big Mom, and they're the girls. I don't want to go be a third or fourth wheel. Come on, Boogie on. We can find you someone down there in Vegas. We can always find you a friend, friend of a friend. Nikki Nichols, if you're watching, shout out to him. Maybe he could hook up with us out there. So. Just come on down there. Vegas is always fun, right, Big Bon?
Oh, yeah. It's going to be fun. It's going to be fun. Exciting.
Yeah. So, it should be exciting. So, like I said, so I will be just the programming note. I'll be shooting from Vegas and putting out videos still. Me and Big Bon will probably be on Skype. I'll be live at the casino. So, it should be good, guys. It should be really, really fun. I'm looking forward to it. These are the days, and I told Big Bon that starting in October, once MLB starts winding down and football is in full force, I go out there with along with the wife, and we're out there betting. Almost every weekend, or at least three times a month, we're out in Vegas. So should be good, Big Bon. I'll be waiting for you there October 18th. And what you got for me today, Big Bon? How are you liking your Packers for tomorrow? What do you got on that? Anything good?
Hey, man, Aaron Rodgers looking like a bad man, just like Stephen A. Smith likes to say, a bad man.
Bad man.
Uh-huh. For sure, man. But I know watching his interviews in the locker room and stuff like that, like he wants to complete more passes and have more big plays. And so I guess like he's not getting enough from his offense, and that's crazy because we're 3-0 and he still wants more. So that's like that tells you his determination and his drive for the team, you know. So he's definitely looking to have a big step or a big leap on these next couple of weeks coming up. And yeah, man, just look for Aaron Rodgers to dominate. I think right now the point spread is 5.5, so that's 2 field goals when you look at it. And I mean, it's possible. I mean, it's gonna be at Lambeau again.
Yeah.
And yeah, man, you know how I feel about the opposite team. I don't want to, bash the opposite team, but
no disrespect to you, Philly fan, and your Phillies. Yeah, I know. You know, the number's a little weird. It's 4.5, so it might be for sure up to 5 before the game starts tomorrow. What do you think? That 4.5? I mean, I know Dave, shout out to Dave LA. He was liking a teaser of teasing the Packers down and teasing the total down. Do you see this as an over game or an under game, Big Mo? What do you think? It's 46 right now, over and under. What do you think?
Man, I mean, the Packers defense, we're doing pretty good. Shout out to my boy Fadal Brown. You know, he played with us on FIU, so shout out to him. But now the defense right now is pretty good. We're doing pretty good. I feel like we can hold the Eagles to, like, maybe a field goal and a touchdown, you know? No disrespect, Philly fan. But our defense is going to eat you guys alive in Lambeau Field. I would lean under in the Packers.
Okay. Well, guys, if you want the bold prediction for tomorrow on our video, myself and Big Mom will be on, of course, as always, here, and we'll have a play for sure. It's a standalone game, so be careful, but we will definitely have a pick on that on our premium play. And again, if you guys want our premium play, speaking of premium plays, $29.99 gets you all the whole month. If you're not on there, again, you are losing money literally, because yesterday, Big Mon and myself, Jared Philly, were on the live channel and we killed it on the WNBA. WNBA, I know you're saying, wait a minute, Joe, it was -4. I pushed. Yes, you pushed if you got a pregame, which I did. I pushed. But yep. Big Mon, myself, Philly, we all hammered it. -1.5, -2.5, money line, and we even got +3.5 on the Mystics. Right, Big Mon? I mean, how could you not bet that? That's what I'm saying to you guys. If you're not in the live channel with us, that alone is worth the $30 a month. I mean, guys in there were betting it left and right and making some good money on that, and also on the Rangers. If you guys want myself and Big Mon's full record on live betting, come on in and check it out. We don't hide anything. We bet our bets. We put them up there. They're timestamped, and everybody follows them along, and we win. Right, Big Mon? Tell me about how good live betting is doing, Big Mon. Not to toot your horn.
Yeah, live betting was doing, it was great last night. And yesterday we was actually on the San Francisco, we're talking about baseball, San Francisco Giants in Colorado to go over. I think it was at 9.5 and Colorado did that themselves, you know. Yeah. So so we, you know, live betting is like where is that, man? Like that's where the most money will be made for sure. Yeah. If you come join the Discord, because live betting is you can get real good lines, you know, like the Mystics went down early and you got them at a +3.5, +1.5, like then you got them on a money line +135.
Yeah.
And they came back and won the game. So it's like live betting is like where is that, man? You get really good lines and I mean if you don't know how to live bet, look at this man right here, Joe, and he's gonna show you everything.
Yeah, no, you know what? But it is, thank you, Big Up. But it is a lot of work in there, guys, and that's why I tell guys that are in there. We sit in there, we're in the live chat, and I'm literally have all my monitors on. I have my TV on. I'm watching the lines drop with the Mystics. Perfect example. The Mystics were favored by 4.5 at 4.
Yeah.
So I said, if I'm getting anything under that, I'm hammering it, which I did, and a lot of guys followed. But so if you guys are not familiar, you guys are watching this video, come on in. I know it's a scary proposition betting live, you don't know how, but once you get the feel of it, all you got to do is click that mouse or punch it on your phone. It becomes very easy, Big Man. It becomes very easy and you feel a lot better. And guess what? It's rewarding. You make money. Now, I'm not saying I don't make money pregame, I do, but sometimes when I have a bad day in pregame or I push or I'm down, let's say 2 units, I make it right back up in live betting. And I know Big Man has been there on some of these big plays, and that's what we're going to be continuing doing for football. College, NBA coming. I'm going to love the NBA. Once teams get down, same principle, you bet it. You know, when it's just a lot of stuff you're missing out if you're not in the live chat with us or in the Discord or getting our pre-game plays. $30 gets you all that. And me and Big Man love helping you guys win money. Right, Big Man? Because what? Yeah. We want to help them win money. We don't want to make money off them. We want money from the bookies. Thank you.
Right? Yes, sir. We want to beat the books, man. We're trying to rob the books. We're not trying to rob you guys. You're robbing the books.
Yeah. And it's very easy in there. Like I said, I know it sounds easy, but it is. Once you get in there, Big Man knows, you'll get the hang of it. We're in there. We're all talking. We're all coaching you through the games. And it's, very, very, very profitable. So, anyway, so speaking of profitable, we lost our video play yesterday with the Rays. We all were on there. Maybe all four of us was a bad luck. I don't know. Maybe. I don't know. I mean, maybe Big Man and I have our little separate plays. So, what do we got today, Big Man, on the free video play for the audience? I really want to win. What do we got for today, Big Man? What
you looking at? All right. Well, today, Milwaukee's trying to clinch their division, so they got to keep winning. And get that wild card spot and everything like that. So right. I look for Milwaukee to roll through. I know Sonny Gray yesterday, I was on the mound, and Milwaukee still beat them bad, 4-2. Today they're sending out Jordan Lyles. And I like this kid, man. Came from Pittsburgh, and, he was kind of in a downswing at Pittsburgh. But I guess, if you're on a star team, you're not going to want to play good, right? But now he's on a good team that's actually looking to go to a postseason. He's pitching really well, man, in all these last couple of starts. And look for him to dominate Cincinnati today.
Yeah.
And so I'm going with Jordan Lyles, and you're getting at a great price right now, -150. You can't beat that price. You can't beat that price. It should be -200, but it's -150. They show respect to Cincinnati being at home, because Cincinnati is always a great team at home. Yeah. So they're showing that respect. So take Milwaukee today, man. Milwaukee -5. -150 on the money line.
On the money line.
And on the money line, and you should get the win today for sure.
Yeah, and I look at the line right here on my book. Like I said, I do have 145. I have 150, so that is a good line. And again, I'm going to make a note here that I'll be betting that pre again. And like I tell you guys, I bet the games pre, either half a unit or a unit, and then I'm going to make a note to bet this live. If the Brewers go down, like Big Mom says, they need these games. They're doing good without Yelich. I'm going to take the Brewers on the money line, or maybe if they even go down a lot more, and this is a key strategy I use in live betting and got people known there. If they go down maybe 3 runs and the book is giving me Brewers +2.5, I'm going to jump on that +2.5 on the run line. Makes
sense. Oh, yeah. So, oh, yeah. I'll be all over that.
Yeah. So, again, you just got to trust your capping, be in the live betting, and you'll make this money. So, again, that is the note I'm running down for this game. Brewers money line pregame and to bet Brewers if they go down at all. And I like that. Okay, Big Man, that's good. Like I said, again, just getting people pointers on live betting. So to my game, of course, I'm going to do the Dodgers as always here. Yesterday, got a little lucky, I said, because, they had a bullpen day, but they still did well. They covered that first 5-run line. Yeah. I actually got a push on the over and under, which was, decent. It was a little 9 push. But today, I got Ross Stripling versus Dennison Lamet. you know, out in San Diego. So here I'm a little torn. I think the 8.5, you might have some action here on the over. But I don't want to, I want to stay away from that. I think what I want to do is if you guys could get a team total for the Padres, it's 3.5, I think. That might not be a bad play. I'm looking at that, you know. But again, if you get a better line live, then do it. A lot of guys also bet the team totals live, which another point. If it goes down to 2.5 or 1.5, jump on it. So I do see some runs here. Again, another play. If you do like also the Dodgers first 5 run line, that's at -135. So again, I gave you guys 3 plays, but kind of use your judgment. Bet them all accordingly. Don't go crazy. Like I said, a quarter unit, maybe a half unit. Again, Big Ma and I always talk about this. Use moderation in your bankroll. Do not go crazy. I know a lot of people will mess. Oh, Joe, do you love this play? I want to bet 10 units. No, I love it, but I'll never bet 10 units on something. I'll always keep moderation because I want to keep my bankroll going. Right, Big Ma? I mean, can you tell us a little about bankroll? Because a lot of people, like I said, want to go crazy on some of these plays.
Yeah, for sure. Bankroll management is key, for sure. And on top of that, you want to bet every single day. If you today's card is kind of iffy, you know. Yeah. And if you don't see something that you absolutely truly like, then don't bet on it, you know. And then if you guys have any questions, for sure, come in our DMs and ask us questions. I'm always getting DMs by people, and you know, asking questions about, you know, bankroll management, how much should I put on a play, whatever the case might be. And I don't know everybody's bankroll, so I would never tell you to bet this much on a game. You know, I don't know your bankroll, you know. So yeah, if you come in my DMs and you ask me any questions, or Joe, or, you know, Philly Fan, or Jared, whoever, and we'll answer your questions. You know, we're not going to just leave you out there in the open waters. You know, we're going to help you swim. So for sure, you know, just come in the DMs and ask us any help, any advice we can give you. We're going to for sure, you know, help you out, you know, that, cause that's what we're here for, to help you guys out.
Yep. And that's good advice. Like I said, I always get DMs all day and people say, oh, I'm going to, you know, just like I always tell people, bet moderate. If your normal bets are one unit, and live betting is a perfect example, I tell them, all right, take it to half unit. You know, if you want to keep betting it, then take it to a quarter unit. So use that same principle, like I said, in pregames and in live, and you will surely come on top. Because like I said, it's a long run. I always say it's a marathon, not a sprint. And especially if you do live betting, you'll get some good action and, you know, like I said, get profit. So thank you, Big Mom, for that. And I guess that's it. So to wrap it up, like I said, so we get to start watching these games. Again, I'll see you and your girlfriend on the 18th, sure. I'll be there this weekend to see Appleseed and a couple other guys that are coming from L.A. will be there in Vegas. So it should be fun. Should be a big you're going to have your big football play. So I'll be sure to, you know, put that ticket up on this weekend when we place that bet. And it'll be fun. So, again, for myself, for our friend Big Mon, please, like I said, come join us. You know, $29.99 gets you everything, sgdwins.com. You get all the premium plays, all of our personal plays, and all of the live betting plays, which, like I said, are kicking butt, and Big Mon's kicking butt. So, thank you. Big Mon, take us away.
Yes, sir. Let's get it.
Yes, sir. And see you guys later. See you on the chat, guys. Peace.